Given f of x equals negative 2x squared minus 3x plus 7, calculate the following function values. First, we have f of 0. To determine f of 0, we substitute 0 for x. F of 0 is equal to negative 2 times the square of 0 minus 3 times 0 plus 7. Simplifying and using the order of operations, we have 0 minus 0 plus 7, which indicates f of 0 equals 7. If f of 0 equals 7, if we were to graph the function f of x, the ordered pair 0 comma 7 would represent one point on the graph. To determine f of 3, we substitute 3 for x, which indicates f of 3 is equal to negative 2 times the square of 3 minus 3 times 3 plus 7. Again, simplifying using the order of operations, we square 3 first. The square of 3 is 9. Negative 2 times 9 is negative 18. Minus 3 times 3 simplifies to minus 9, and then plus 7. Negative 18 minus 9 is negative 27. Plus 7 is negative 20. F of 3 equals negative 20, which indicates, again, if we were to graph the function, the ordered pair 3 comma negative 20 would be one point on the graph of the function. Next, we have f of negative 3. To find f of negative 3, we substitute negative 3 for x. F of negative 3 is equal to negative 2 times the square of negative 3 minus 3 times negative 3 plus 7. Again, simplifying using the order of operations, we simplify the exponents first. The square of negative 3 is positive 9. Negative 2 times positive 9 is negative 18. Then we have minus 3 times negative 3, which simplifies to plus 9, and then plus 7. Simplifying, negative 18 plus 9 is negative 9. Negative 9 plus 7 is negative 2. F of negative 3 equals negative 2, which again indicates the ordered pair negative 3 comma negative 2 would be one point on the graph of f of x. Next, we have f of negative x. The result of this is going to be a different function of x. Recall from transformations, f of negative x is the reflection of f of x across the y-axis. To determine f of negative x, we substitute negative x for x in f of x, which gives us negative 2 times the square of negative x minus 3 times negative x plus 7. Simplifying, the square of negative x is x squared. Negative 2 times x squared is negative 2x squared. Minus 3 times negative x simplifies to plus 3x, and then we have plus 7. And again, if we were to look at the graph of this function, it would be the graph of the original function f of x reflected across the y-axis. And then finally, we have f of the quantity x plus 2. Recall, f of the quantity x plus 2 is the function that shifts the original function f of x left 2 units. To determine f of the quantity x plus 2, we substitute x plus 2 for x in the function f of x, which gives us negative 2 times the square of x plus 2 minus 3 times the quantity x plus 2 plus 7. Let's go ahead and simplify. The first step is to square x plus 2. Recall there are no shortcuts to square x plus 2. We have two factors of x plus 2. When multiplying two binomials, we have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. The square of x plus 2 is equal to x squared plus 2x plus 2x plus 4, giving us x squared plus 4x plus 4, which means above we have negative 2 times the quantity x squared plus 4x plus 4, and then minus 3 times the quantity x plus 2, which is minus 3x minus 6. And we still have plus 7. And now we'll go ahead and distribute the negative 2, which gives us negative 2x squared minus 8x minus 8 minus 3x, and then minus 6 plus 7 simplifies to plus 1. Combining like terms one more time, we have negative 2x squared. And then we have negative 8x minus 3x, which simplifies to minus 11x. And negative 8 plus 1 simplifies to minus 7. I hope you found this helpful.